Southwest Florida. Welcome back to Leaf Pitch Live. So glad you stayed with us on this Sunday morning. Got a fabulous show lined up for you here at the Police Athletic League of the City of Fort Myers. We'll get a chance to talk to Yvette Dominique, officer for the Fort Myers Police Department, and she does the youth programming here. She does an outstanding job with youth outreach. Tisha and Toya finally making it back to give you what's going on in Southwest Florida. What's going on with Tisha and Toya on Leaf Pitch Live? Be a part of this segment, and then you know it, Cindy Banier for Congress. She'll be right here to tell us all about her perspective on things, and it's going to be fabulous. It's the political season, and it's happening on Leaf Pitch Live. We'll be right back. Southwest Florida, welcome back to Leaf Pitch Live. So thrilled to get our next guest in here. It's the incomparable, the undescribable officer, Yvette Dominique of the Fort Myers Police Department. Let's bump you in, Smiley. Good to get you back on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Congratulations on being a 2021 Leaf Pitch Live Person of the Year.
Well, thank you very much.
I was so happy that you were able to get that award and for people to see all the good work that you do.
Thank you. It was an honor.
Mm-hmm. And one of the, your award talked about your work with youth development.
Mm-hmm.
That brings us right here in the heart of the matter.
Yes, the Police Athletic League.
The Police Athletic League. And I think it's another name y'all call it also that deals with education. Go ahead and say that.
Where our building is called the Youth Relations Center.
Right, that's going to be hard for me to remember.
It's YRC.
Okay, tell us why you call it that.
Basically, we take care of, when it comes to sports, academics, anything that kids can get involved in, is done out of this building, and it's basically for our teens in the community. So we decided to call it the Youth Relations Center.
Right, because see, when you say police athletically, just that word athletic, mm-hmm. you just connotate that it's all about sports. But relation takes in everything.
Exactly.
The human, the family, everything, and taking care of our youth and our community and making, trying to make their life better. What are some ways that you guys are doing that?
Right now we're doing tutoring. Our tutoring program for the kids is mandatory. If you're a part of our program, we're asking parents to sign their kids up for tutoring. We also do family functions here. We invite the families and the kids to come out and, you know, partake in, you know, what we do. We believe that it takes a village. We believe that nothing can happen without the parents. So we like to bring parents and kids together. Mm-hmm. That's one of the things that we do here at the Powell Building.
Mm-hmm. Tell me, what's your role here as a law enforcement officer?
Our youth usually, when they come in contact with law enforcement, it's usually on a negative. You go to a home, it's either on DV, it's either kids that are in a vehicle for a traffic stop or something like that. Sometimes we want to give them an opportunity to see us on a positive note. So we come here, we play basketball with them, football, get them in the ring, do a little, you know, boxing. Sometimes we just want to sit down and have a conversation with them, mm-hmm. and just kind of get to understand what they're going through. So with us, we believe that kids want somebody to listen to them. So as an officer, we sometimes just sit and listen.
Well, PAL certainly made a difference in my life. I grew up in the PAL program, and I'm so happy that we have a program here with the City of Fort Myers Police Department and have a standalone building out here in East, yes. Fort Myers. Tell people where you're located and how they can get involved, whether they want to volunteer, put their children in the program, just a whole gamut of helping our community.
Well, we are currently located at the old, we're at Shady Oaks Park, 3280 Marion Street. We basically are open between, I want to say we start opening around 12 for the public, between 12 and 8. Because we have martial arts here, wrestling, boxing. Sometimes our football players come over here and practice as well. We also do our tutoring here weekly. We have our Explorer program, our Young Leos program, which is youth, young leaders educating others. We have our Youth Directors program. We have so many other programs that are coming out of this building. So if you want to come in, if your kid is not an athlete, that's fine. Bring them here because we have a mentoring program. If you want to have a place where you could just bring your kids to have a conversation with an officer, this is the place to come and do it.
Males and female.
Male and female.
The age range.
Here at this building, we try to gear it towards teens, so 13 and up, 13 to 18. But we have had kids who are 12. It just depends on the program that we're actually currently doing. Our youth director's program is from 12 to 14.
You know. Say here at this building, that means that there's some other locations as well?
No, there is no other location. We do go out to other locations, but this is our main home.
Okay.
We do, like I said, with football, we go out to Prince Street. If you're interested in football, we out there right now doing football. But currently, everything we have is here at this building, the Youth Relations Center.
Mm-hmm. PAL is here. The Fort Myers Police Athletic League, or PAL, as it is popularly called, is an important part of Chief Diggs' community engagement initiative to bring sports programs to young children and teenagers that promote strong character, positive life skills. Sports include football, basketball, and boxing programs. There's also cheerleading. For more information, contact Senior Program Coordinator Keith White at 239-896-7191 or email him at dwhite@fmpolice.com.
I noticed that it looks like some construction is going on over there. Are you excited about a new football field being built?
I am excited. That just means our entire location, everything we have will be right here. This will be the actual home of Police Athletic League. I can't wait for our kids to be able to come out here and play football practice. Mm-hmm. It'll be interesting because then our parents can actually be involved more in our building volunteer-wise. So mm-hmm. it's an amazing thing.
And people seeing over your shoulder, they see the boxing rink all set up. Looks like a good workout. You don't necessarily have to be a competitive boxer, but you can get a good workout and just learn how self-defense.
Yes.
Can you expound on that if you please?
So we do have, for this camp, we have our Tierra Brown. She is Officer Brown. She does intro to boxing. So if you wanted to get involved, she teaches you the basic skills of
That's
what
a
boxing
champion.
Is. Yes, she is.
Mm-hmm.
She's amazing. If you ever get to, yeah, I know everybody
She's
knows
been on
Tierra.
The show.
Everybody knows her, but she has
She's
an amazing
been on
personality.
She's been on Leap Is Live.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Amazing personality, but she is the one that comes out and teaches our kid basic boxing, which incorporates the discipline and commitment to the art.
And Tierra doesn't play around.
No, she doesn't.
She didn't get to where she was playing around.
No, she doesn't.
And I understand now she's a, well, you mentioned it, but I didn't know that she was now a police officer.
Yes, she is. She is a police officer with us, and we are extremely happy to have her
Well,
here.
People better be careful not running up on her thinking they could, she's going to break out some hands,
okay.
man. The
you
Olympia.
Don't even see it coming with that smile,
you
right?
You never know what people know, do you?
Yep.
Hey, man, you got to cool it on that noise, Skinny. Let's go to the, you mentioned a tutorial program. I want you to expound on that. That's after school or, and right now we're in summer camp. So mm-hmm. things are going on here as well?
Yes. So right now we have summer camp and with tutoring, we're keeping up with reading, language arts, math, so that the kids are not taking that break from school. We want to make sure that we believe that when you're doing sports, it is very important for you to stay in school. Education is number one here. Mm-hmm. And we all believe that. So that's what we do here. We can't tell them, hey, go to school and do great. But if you don't give them the tools in order for them to be great. So mm-hmm. that's one of the things we do here with our tutoring program. So the tutoring is Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
But for the summer, it's all week. We mm-hmm. do it Monday through Friday.
Talk about the support that you get here from the highest person in the department, Chief Derek Diggs.
Chief Diggs, our number one, he loves PAL. PAL is his dream. He's a PAL kid himself.
Mm-hmm.
So he definitely supports everything we do here. He comes by and, you know, sees the kids every now and then. You know, you would be surprised. Every time he sees the kids, that's when you want to see him smile.
Mm-hmm.
Those who say they've never seen him smile, come here. You'll see him smiling.
I'm looking forward to coming over and talking to the kids as well. Yep. I mentioned that this is summer camp now, so they've gone on a field trip to the swimming pool.
Yes.
So your summer program, I saw this morning they were doing exercise. Yes. Well, talk about that. You out there leading exercises.
Oh, yeah. So I know people.
What does that do? Get their mind right?
It gets them. It helps them get ready. It gets them. It pumps them up for them to be able to accept what we're giving them. Because like I told you, we do education. We do know the law, which is we teach them, you know, what's right and what's wrong. We believe that if you don't educate the kids when it comes down to knowing the law, then you're doing them a disgrace. Mm-hmm. So we definitely do. So in order for us to be able to educate them, you got to get them pumping. You got to get them ready. And let me tell you, they're killing me out there. Mm-hmm. They're definitely killing me out there.
That's okay.
Yeah.
But you love it, right?
I love it. It's amazing. You can tell I love it. Come on. I'd rather be here, you know, every day, making an impact and a difference in a kid's life.
Let's give some love to Sergeant Lamar Campbell. When in the early days is when it was being talked about. He used to come on my show, say, 4 or 5 years ago. It seemed like this was one of his dreams to be part of making this happen as well.
Yeah, his main dream was to get a football team here, and he definitely did. We have their Stingray football team. The Stingrays are doing amazing things this year. You know, we're ready for, I believe it's this summer. We're starting right now, we're recruiting. So if you have kids who are interested in football right now, this is the time to sign up. You know, we're definitely gearing up for this year.
And let's shout out our program director. He's taking the kids on a field trip. Keith White.
He's having so much fun right now. Keith is an amazing.
My fraternity brother, Phi Beta Sigma.
Yeah, he is an amazing person. He does a lot here with us at the Police Athletic League. He coordinates everything here. So he's always going. He's always doing
something.
He is. He's definitely amazing. Everybody loves Mr. Keith.
Right. Yeah. Legend in the community. Goes way back. Always working with the youths.
Yep.
What does it do for you personally to know that you're impacting the children in our community in this way?
For me personally, I could retire right now. Mm-hmm. I could definitely retire because I know that I have definitely made connections with kids and I have made an impact. They've also made an impact in my life. Mm-hmm. You know, I love getting up every morning. I love coming to work. I do it for them, you know, mm-hmm. because what gets you is when you're walking through the streets and some kids who have never seen a female officer before, a female black officer, you know, and when they see me, they want to look at me and they want to be like, oh my God, are you a real police officer? Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, and you could be one too, mm-hmm. you know, so it does a lot for me.
Mm-hmm. The long-term goal, if you had a crystal ball and you could just draw out the long-term goal of the PAL program, anything you'd like to add to it or see happen in the future?
I would love to see a track. Our kids love
that
to run.
Be big here.
Yeah, we have amazing. A lot of our kids are fast. You know, mm-hmm. I'd love to see a track. I'd love to see a tennis court. You know, rugby. You know, just soccer. You know, I would love to see an area where kids can, if there's a sport that they want to do, that they could come here and get it all. Mm-hmm. You know, I'd love to have an area where the kids who are a STEM program, those who are not, you know, athletic, but their brains are, you know, the it's magic, you know. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's not just about body, it's about the mind. Mm-hmm. And so that's something that we do here at the PAL program, and I would love to see it just expand and be just great.
Mm-hmm. Do you speak Creole?
Wimbali Creole.
Come on, tell you.
Bien, yes.
Sac passé?
I just said I'm fine.
I know. I don't know what I'm just trying to act like I know something. I didn't know a little something.
So I'll just say, Nom se Yvette Diana de Saline Dominique. Mm-hmm. Papa m'se moun go naïf. E mande tout moun ki de yoa ki gen Simon vin la nan building 32 Marion Street. Police Athletic League.
See, there you give my show international flavor.
There you go.
All right. Well, that's been a privilege, a pleasure to have you on the show. Looking forward to getting you back in the future.
Well, thank you for having me.
All right, stay right there. As the saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, they are usually interrupted by those like Officer Yvette Dominique of the City of Fort Myers Police Department in the PAL program who are doing it. And remember, Miami has the oranges, but Fort Myers got the
juice.
We got the juice.
We got the juice.
We'll be right back.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime. And also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.